Good morning, students. In the last class, we have seen the module 4. In the module 4, we have seen the introduction to transducers, the definition of transducer, as well as we have seen the classification of transducers and then mechanical transducer. Okay, these are the contents of the last video. Now, in the next video, we will see the different types of electrical transducers. So, as we have seen, transducers are nothing but the devices which converts the one form of energy into another form. Okay, so we will see now electrical transducers. So the first type what we have, that is electrical resistive transducers. Okay, so it works on the principle that the resistance of the conductor is directly proportional to length of the conductor and inversely proportional to the area of the conductor. That we know that R is directly proportional to length and indirectly proportional to area. So from the definition, from the equation, we can see that is length is directly proportional and area is inversely proportional, and we have separated with a constant rho, that is stands for resistivity. Okay, so by using this principle, suppose if I change the length, so that the change in, there will be a change in resistance. Okay, if there is change in area, then there will be a change in resistance. Okay, so by using this principle, you can use this application in the different cases of resistive transducers. Okay, so this rho stands for resistivity of the material. So here changing the area is a little bit complicated, so that we can change the length. So changing the length will be easier part. So that application we have seen in some of the cases. Okay, so here the rho stands for resistivity of the conductor, R is resistance, L is length, and A is area of cross section. Okay, so in the case of sliding contact devices, this is one of the application of resistive transducers. So we'll see the parts now. So there will be a slider. That slider will be move over this rod, that is called as guide rod, and there will be a resistance element what they have placed between these two supports. That is support, we can say it as A, and this support as B, and that is connected to the A output reading. Okay, this is the input and we can say the output over here. So this is what it indicates. Now it converts the mechanical displacement into voltage output. As a slider moves, the length changes, in terms resistance also changes. Okay, so in this application, if you start from the location 0, if you take the location A, the equation A stands for 0. From 0 to, if it is moving towards B, then the length will be changing. So whenever the slider is at A, the length is 0. Whenever it moves towards B, the length will be changing. As the length of this contact will be changing, there will be a change in resistance also. Okay, that change in resistance can be identified by using the output terminals. Okay, this change in resistance can be recorded. Okay, this is application of sliding contact devices. So next we'll see potentiometer. So as the sliding contact moves, the resistance also changes. In this rotary type arrangement of the wires wrapped around the card. Okay, see this potentiometer, it is a circular arrangement, rotary arrangement of a sliding contact. The sliding contact is connected over here. So when it rotates over this distance, the length of the wire will change. When the length of the wire will change, the resistance will be changing. That can be recorded by using a output terminals. Okay, this is a sliding contact and this is the wires, the resistant wires, and this is the input voltage what we are providing for this. Okay, so this is about two applications of resistive transducers. So one more we have, that is in the case of strain gauge. So it is a fine wire which changes its electrical resistance when it's mechanically strained. The change in resistance of the strain gauges can be measured using Wheatstone bridge. Okay, so we have seen the strain gauge, it used to measure the strain. The strain is converted into electrical signal so that we can get the output voltage. So we have seen that this strain gauge we have used in load cell. So load cell is used to measure the weight of any material. Okay. So now this strain gauge they have placed below the load cell. Okay. So when we place the load over the load cell, that there will be a deformation in this wires. Okay, there will be a small deformation in this wire grid. See, this wire grid is placed over the carrier. Okay, so because of the deformation of this wire grid, there will be a change in length. Due to the change in length, there will be a change in resistance. The change in resistance can be identified the terminals, and it will be sent as electrical signal and can be converted into again digital form, and we will get the results in the display. Okay, that is in the case of load cell. So same kind of applications we have in a thermocouple, thermistor, as well as RTD. So RTD stands for resistance thermal detector. So in the case of strain gauge, we are using this Wheatstone bridge. Okay, so Wheatstone bridge, we have seen that there are four resistance. One of the resistance is connected to this wire grid, and one of the resistance that is the connect to the output link. Okay, so that we can see the output in the R4, that is resistance 4. Okay, so this is about the brief part about strain gauge. We will study in detail about strain gauge in the module 5. Okay, so next we will move on to the next step, that is inductive transducer. Okay, so when a single coil, so we'll see the figure first. There will be a meter for measuring this inductance, and we have an exciter, means it is a supply, and then we have a rod which is wounded with the wire. Okay, and this is conductive wire, and the armature moment will be there. So we can move this armature, or we can move this component, and there will be air gap between these two components. Okay, so we can display, we can move this air gap, so this component, to change this air gap. Okay, so when a single coil is used as a transducer element, the mechanical input changes the permeance of the flux path generated by the coil, thereby changing its inductance. Okay, the change in inductance can be measured using a suitable circuit indicating the value of the input. Okay, so when we will pass the current through this circuit, or through this wire, so it will generate a magnetic flux. So it will generate a magnetic flux. Okay, the flux generated over here also. Suppose if I move this component, the flux generated will be changed. Okay, when flux generated will be changed, that change can be identified by using this meter. Okay, so we'll identify some changes here. That change is due to the change in this air gap. So air gap changes means the permeance will be the changes of the permeance. Okay, so when it changes, there will be change reading, the change in reading can be recorded. This is the application of this inductive transducer. Okay, so this type of transducer we can see in a metal detector. So we can see in the normally when we go to malls, there will be in the entry we have metal detector, or you can see in the railway stations as well as in the airport we have metal detector. So this is that is application of this inductive transducer. Okay, so this is a second type of transducer. In inductive we have two types, that is it may be if they are using a single coil, then we can say it is a self inductive transducer. They are using two different coils and they are changing its fluxes, then we can say it is mutual inductive transducers. Okay, so this is about inductive transducers. Then we will see about the piezoelectric transducer. This is the third type of electrical transducers. The example what they have given, that is gallium phosphate polyvinylidene fluoride. Okay, this is an example. It is one of the material or one of the piezoelectric material. Okay, what is this piezoelectric effect, or what is this piezoelectric materials? Okay, when a piezoelectric material is subjected to stress or force, it generates electrical potential or voltage proportional to the magnitude of the force. This phenomenon is called as piezoelectric effect. Suppose if you have a cube of piezoelectric material, okay, that is placed between the two electrodes. Suppose if you apply the force from the top and bottom, suppose you press it, so there will be a generation of electrical signal, okay, due to the applied force. That kind of material we can say it is a piezoelectric material. So how much amount of voltage will be generated? That we will see. Piezoelectric crystal is placed between the two plate electrodes. When the force F is applied to the plates, the stress will be produced in the crystal, and the corresponding deformation the induced charge, that is Q is equal to D into F. So D stands for piezoelectric constant and F stands for force applied. So how much voltage it will generate? The output voltage, that is E, that is equal to G into T into P. So where T stands for, it depends upon the crystal thickness T, and G is voltage sensitivity constant, and P is impressed pressure. Okay. The voltage generated E, that is equal to G into T into P. Okay. So here you can see the arrangement. So there in the top we have one type of electrode plate, and in the bottom also we have one type of electrode plate. In between they have placed the piezoelectric crystal, okay, of thickness T, and the two terminals are connected to the output voltage. When you apply the force F, it will generate the voltage. The voltage amount is E equal to G into T into P. P stands for pressure. Pressure is how much force divided by the area. Force by area is nothing but pressure, and this is the thickness of the crystal, and this G stands for, it's a constant voltage sensitivity. Okay, so this is about piezoelectric effect as well as piezoelectric transducer. Okay, this is the one more type of electrical transducer. Okay, so next we will move on to one more type, that is photoelectric transducer. Okay, photoelectric transducer. So photo stands for light rays. Okay, when the light rays strikes photoemissive cathode, it releases electrons which are attracted towards the anode, thereby producing an electric current in the circuit. The photoelectric current I is equal to S into F. S stands for sensitivity, F stands for illumination of the cathode. Okay. See, suppose a photo, if you sub when the photo light rays fall on the cathode, it will generate electrons. This electrons will be attracted by the anode. So here anode is present. So because of the attraction of the electrons by the anode, there will be a flow of electrons. When there will be a flow of electrons, there will be a current passing through the circuit that we can measure by using the output terminals. Okay, that photoelectric current, that is I, is equal to S into F. S stands for sensitivity and into F stands for illumination of the cathode. Okay, that the cathode is a kind of material which will generate the electrons when light rays falls on it. Okay, this is photoelectric transducer. As we know that this transducer is what? This is nothing but conversion of one form of energy into another form. Here the light rays is converted into electrical signal. Okay, similarly we have one more type, that is photovoltaic transducer. So here we see the arrangement now. So conductor, the conductor is placed between top and bottom part, that is a conductor upper contact. So this is the output voltage what we are measuring. So it's a conductor base, conductor upper contact. Okay, and then the radiations are falling on here, that is incoming radiations, that is P doped semiconductor. So in the top it is nothing but a diode arrangement. In the top we have P doped semiconductor, and the bottom we have N doped semiconductor. In between, when the light rays falls on it, it will create a depletion region, that is PN junction. Okay, so this is a diodic principle. So whenever We'll see the phenomenon in which when the light energy is converted into electrical energy. Okay, so photovoltaics means nothing but the light is converted into electrical energy is called as photovoltaic effect. When the photon or a light rays strikes over the thin p-doped upper layer, they are absorbed by it. Okay, so see, whenever the radiations are fall on the p-doped material, so it will absorb the radiations. So normally p-doped material is nothing but it's having holes. In the case of n-doped material is having electrons. So holes are positive and the n-doped are negative. N is nothing but it's having electrons. These are negative. So when are positive as well as negative. So when we incident the electric radiations over it, the energy is absorbed by the p-doped materials. Okay. So electrons in the n layer, which causes the formation of conduction of electrons and holes. Okay. These conduction electrons and holes are separated by a depletion region potential of the p-n junction. When the load is connected across the cell, the depletion region potential causes the photocurrent to flow through the load. Okay, so when we have these holes as well as electrons in the depletion region, in that case, if you connect a load between this, so that the load will pass through a current, because of this the flow of electrons as well as holes in the depletion region. Okay, that is due to this we can generate the electric current, that is because of the incident rays fall on the surface of the p-doped material. Okay, so this effect we can say it is a photovoltaic effect. Okay, so we have seen now the five types of electric transducers that will be there in your syllabus. That is, first one we have seen resistive transducers, as well as we have seen inductive, and then we have seen piezoelectric transducers, then we have seen photoelectric, and then photovoltaic transducers. Totally we can say that transducers stands for, it converts the one form of energy into another form. So during this process we can see some mechanical changes. There will be a change in resistance, there will be a change in inductance, there will be a change in the power generated by the element. So these changes can be identified, that can be used as a application in the case of measurement. Okay, this is applications of electrical transducers. Okay, so thank you. Submit the some write this content in your class notes, as well as I will give a quiz answer that quiz. Okay, thank you very much.